He is also a contributing editor for many publications. He's a writer for Surface Magazine and Black Book Magazine, among others. His areas of expertise include media strategy, branding, creative direction, and publicity. He got his Master's of Science degree in media management at the New School in 2012. Anybody know about the New School? That is a good place to go to school, isn't it? Right down in Manhattan. He also got his bachelor's degree from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State in 2007. So you can do the math. He's a young guy, entrepreneur, making it happen, right? So he's worked with tons of organizations and clients, and just to name a few, the New Lab, Karen Gallo, Raleigh Denham Public School, The Cools, Condé Nast Digital. Do you young people know what these brands are? Okay, because I'm like, oh. Yeah, I would. They'll know, right? I know some of these, right? I need to get more involved or aware, but I'm old lady now. All right, so anyway, he's also worked at the Andy Warhol Foundation, the Portland Institute of Contemporary Art in Oregon, for Makita Eyewear, just tons of stuff. He's the guy who always knows a good opportunity when he sees it, and he's always in the right place at the right time. And it's really about keeping your eyes open, staying networked, and really making good decisions about good uses of your time, right? And so without further ado, let me just turn it over to our guest. We appreciate you coming from New York, JJ, and without further ado, let's just welcome him and say hello.
I'm really excited to be here, and she gave me a little brief. I thought I'd start with just, a little bit letting you know where I come from. So I grew up in a really small town in Southern Oregon, so very far away from New York, and I always was into what you just said. I love learning about everything, a little bit about everything. I'm like, how am I going to make that role? So, I graduated school and I went to Arizona State for the education and the sunshine. But I knew they had a great Cronkite School of Journalism, and that's what I really, really knew I wanted to dive more into. So I went there, I graduated, I was really heavy on the print, but I knew, and this was, in the early 2000, 2003 to 2007, internet was obviously established, but it was still going. I knew it was going to be the wave of the future. So after I graduated from Arizona State, I moved to Portland, Oregon for 2 years, and I worked for a lot of actually nonprofit communication. I was the media director for Defend Oregon, where I was going against, really great education measures, and I was 22 years old, and I was kind of leaving the state in these, and being on public debates, and it was crazy, but amazing opportunity. And I knew I wanted to go back to school, and I researched the programs. I wanted to go to a big city. I wanted to stay in a metropolitan. And the New School actually approached me for my work with them in the Portland Institute of Contemporary Art and a campaign I did with Levi's, which I'll tell you about, and let me know about the program. So they gave me a great scholarship opportunity, and I headed to New York in 2009, actually. And I started. So I've been in New York for about 6 years now, and it's been great. I got my master's degree in media management with an emphasis in digital and merging. And during that time, I'll show you a little bit about what I've done, but I actually was hired as the marketing and events assistant for Paper Magazine. And I was doing it was great. And actually the head style director, his name is Luigi Tadini. He loved the way I was working and my personal style. And he kind of asked me to start going on shoots because I never thought I would do fashion. And I became his full-time assistant at 23. So my first ever styling gig editorial was with the artist Kesha, which was crazy because you like her or don't, but it's not like a small, I'm like, oh God, it's Kesha, you know what I mean? She's kind of big then, so still is, I guess. So then I started styling everyone, and then during my time in graduate school, I did full-time editorial. So I was a fashion editor for a magazine, different magazines. And then I started agency work because I realized I love being a contributing editor, but I'm better at the branding. I'm better at the development for these brands, and I see that. I don't know. I like to put my hands in more of that knowledge. So I started working in agencies, digital media director, and I'll go on with that. I did agency for years. It's a great platform. I learned so much about the different elements of the fashion design industry when it comes to marketing, branding, wholesale and buying, everything. I worked a little bit in e-commerce, and then I decided 2 years ago, I had a few brands ask me, do you want to just work with me on my own? And I'm like, you know what? That's enough to pay the really expensive rent. I can do this. I'm going to be really poor in the beginning, but I can do this. And then Now it's been great. In 2 years, I have 7 routine clients. I have a studio in Soho with my little team, and I work with many, mostly fashion brands that you'll see, some design, and then I can do consulting basis project work with everything from restaurant openings to Condé Nast to setting up panels for detailed magazines, and I'm doing a big one with all the top menswear brands currently. So that's a little bit about me, where I come from, the lineage, and we'll go more into it right now. So, like I said, so you're gonna bear with me because the, my screen is blank, but I can see it up here. So, who we are, J2 Media is a media and branding strategy firm based in Soho, New York. I launched in 2012, and what I saw with agency, and again, it's a great platform to see, but you know, when it comes to PR and media agency, the ones I worked for, anyways, I should say, they were very hungry to get more clients. Like, you know what I mean? It was all about the next. And I realized, you know, you need to establish, I wanted a 360 approach. I'm not gonna just hire new account executives so I can get more clients. My first person I hired was actually an art director for my team, because I wanted to make sure I can not only tell you what we need for your next lookbook seasonal campaign, I want to be able to create it and design it for you if you need to, you know, for that extra fee or you know, whatever we need to do it. So that's how I saw it, and I wanted it, that was my approach. I wanted to give it 360. I wanted to be able to tell you about the brand and the strategy. I wanted to tell you how to make sure your stuff gets in the New York Times, like the other agencies do, but I also want to have that wholesale approach. I'm going to tell you the best retail stores to get into. I might not know them personally, but I have enough advice that I can get you to tell you to get in that Webster in Miami or the Need Supply, along with the Barneys and the Bergdorf's and all of that. So, you know, those are the creative seasonal strategies that I do for domestic and international success and branding. So I'm going to give you a few client case studies. Some of these include current clients, most of them, actually all of them are current clients in one way or another that I'm starting with. Public school menswear. Does anybody familiar with public school menswear? It's all made in New York. We'll get into it right now. They are kind of like, we both kind of started each other's career. They had a relaunch. This is them right there. And this is their branding. So I started working with public school when I was with an agency as a digital media director. And they were part of the first incubator class for the Council of Fashion Designers of America. And that is an organization that, it's a great thing to study if you're interested in fashion. It's one of the leading organizations, I think, in the world. And what they do is they take, for the incubator class, they select every 2 years, it's almost like a university program, where they select about 6 to 10 brands that are American-based. It doesn't have to be made in America, but they are American designers. And it's a college course study. They teach them how to buy, they teach them how to sell, they teach them, tell them the best PR strategies. They bring in people like myself to take on a certain brand and help develop it to become, hopefully, an international success. And that's exactly what happened with public school. So this is the two founders, Maxwell Osborne and Dowie Chow, both, you know, they'd always had the cool factor. Guys always have had the cool factor. So they all were raised in New York. They both started their career together at Sean John. Dowie on the right was the VP, and Maxwell came in as an intern, and they both just jammed, and they started creating stuff and creating a line that was exclusive in Miami, and then they stopped for a few years in 2008 during the recession, and then they relaunched public school with myself in 2012. So they designed it, all made in New York. These are some looks from the first collection. Now, they are amazing at what they do. Again, they have this cool factor. They, you know, they look great, but what was the problem was it's pretty luxury and expensive, made in New York, and in the beginning, it was easily pressworthy, but from the buyer's standpoint, they're like, your consumer base isn't who's gonna buy this $1,200 leather jacket. You know what I mean? They don't have the money for you yet. They're college kids who love you, your complex medias, all of that. So what we did is I worked with them. I worked with him in like, how are we gonna develop your campaigns where it can cross boards and you can be in those markets and you can be in, and that comes in a branding strategy. And that came from my press releases to our muse. Our muse was George Lewis of Twin Shadow. So I don't know if you know the musician Twin Shadow, the band Twin Shadow. George Lewis is the lead singer of it, really great actor. So when we were relaunching, I'm like, how are we going to get that out there? That they're kind of unknown, he's kind of unknown at the time. What are we going to do? So for our invite, I had them go into the studio, dress him, and we had the New York Times illustrator Richard Haynes come in and sketch the art. He did a personal favor, and that went gangbusters. So it went crazy. And I will show you right now a video of their first New York Fashion Week, which was 2012, that we creative directed. And let me see the scroller. So they went gangbusters. I don't
know
what to do.
Missing mouse.
Yeah, missing mouse. Sorry, everyone. So, from a branding and strategy standpoint, I wanted to get them out there. How are we going to get them out there? So that is what the CFDA came to me for. So I knew that we had to do the things with Richard Haynes and Twin Shadow, and how are we going to get, even though we have this cool factor or whatever, nobody outside the industry really knows them. So I knew first I wanted to do what I said with the Richard Haynes invitation, and I also wanted to build a huge publicity video to go along with the slideshows and all that, that can get on the GQs and that can get on the Rolling Stones, because Twin Shadow did the original composition for us. And that's what we did. We had a great filmmaker do it, and we will see if I can show much.